Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise the Lord. We thank you, Father, for the opportunity you've given unto us to preach the gospel, the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ. Today is a day of grace, a day of peace, a day of joy, a day you can make a decision to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life. So we bring to you the good news of our Lord Jesus Christ, that Jesus Christ's arms are all open for you. Jesus is calling everyone. The Bible says unto us, therefore, being justified by faith, being justified by faith, we have peace with the Father. We have peace with God. You can make peace with God today. We have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. So being justified by faith, being welcome into the kingdom of God, being justified. You know, when we say justified, it means being declared righteous. Abraham started this faith business of God. The faith thing we are talking about, the faith Abraham had brought the righteousness. He was given the righteousness of God. He was made righteous because of his faith. So we call unto everyone to make Jesus Christ the Lord of your life. Amen. We call everyone to make Jesus Christ, make a decision to follow Jesus. For Jesus came into the world of darkness. He said, in the world, there is darkness. In the world, there is darkness. But in him, we have peace. In the world, there is darkness. But he that followeth the Lord Jesus Christ shall not walk in darkness. Shall not walk in darkness. Shall not walk in sin. Shall not walk in confusion. Shall not walk in sickness. Shall not walk in the things that the law has brought unto us. You know, anyone that was not able to obey the law is cursed. As Galatians chapter 3:10 says, it says, if you could not be able to obey and continue with the law, you are made cursed. So God is calling everyone today. He's making a hand request for you to come into the kingdom of God. So being justified, being declared righteous, as Abraham started the faith. Abraham believed unto God. Abraham trusted God. And he was acquitted unto him as righteous. He was given unto him as righteous, man. He was so righteous. He's called a friend of God. And in his promise, in the promise of that righteousness given unto Abraham, we also receive the righteousness of God. We also made righteous. So today, probably you are trying to obey the rules and laws. You are trying to keep to the religious activities. You are doing good. You are doing charity. But that will not take you into being peaceful with God. That will not bring peace in your heart. That will not make you to be a child of God. Because God is calling everyone. He said, being justified, being made righteous. Are you trying to be righteous? Are you trying to be righteous? Because the blood of Jesus Christ on the cross made us righteous. You know, the law is a shadow. When you look at the law is a shadow of the things to come forward. The things that are going to come in future. That's the law. The law brought us into this mess. But Jesus Christ came. Jesus Christ came. When he was arrested, he was accused, and he was crucified. Jesus Christ on the cross, he was disconnected from God, and he went to hell for you because he took unto himself all the sins of the whole wide world. Your sins have been paid in the blood of Jesus Christ. So you are made righteous if you believe in Jesus Christ. as the Lord and personal Savior, if you believe in Jesus Christ as the Son of the living God, if you believe in Jesus Christ as a Savior, you've got to believe. You've got to believe. We're not talking about believing as the Satan believed and did not accept that Jesus is the Lord. You can say, I believe that Jesus is my prophet, but that's not where he's going to take you to the kingdom of God. That's not the end point. The end point is that you believe that Jesus Christ is a Savior. His vicarious death on the cross, his sacrifice on the cross paid for your sin. So we have peace. We have peace with the Father. Just as in the world today, there is no peace. Just as in the world today, everyone is calling for peace. We are calling for peace in Russia. We are calling for peace in Ukraine, in the name of Jesus Christ. But for you to have the inside peace, for you to have the peace in a troubled situation, for you to have peace in your family, for you to have peace in your day-to-day activities, for you to have peace in your body, you've got to believe that Jesus Christ is the Son of the living God. You got to believe that Jesus Christ came to rescue you from hell. There is no peace for anyone that refuses Jesus Christ. There is no peace in your heart. There is this guilt in your heart. There is guilt, and no law that you obey can take away the guilt in the hearts of men and women. No law. Abraham did not obey any law. Abraham was called the father of faith. Abraham did not obey law. He believed in God. He trusted in God. So you might be saying, how can I believe? It's very simple. The recipe is in the book. Romans chapter 10 verse 10 says, with the heart, with your spirit, you can believe. With your spirit, you believe unto righteousness. You believe you are made righteous. You don't do good to be righteous. You believe unto God through Jesus Christ's blood, and you are made righteous. That's the recipe. So Jesus Christ is calling you. The kingdom of God is here. Today is the day of grace. Today is the day you can make peace with God. You made a decision to follow Jesus Christ. It shall be well with you. You made a decision not to follow Jesus Christ. You've already said that you are your own God. You are your own God. But God is a spirit. God created a spirit man. God is a spirit. You are a spirit. So you cannot say, I cannot believe. You cannot say, you cannot accuse God of what he has made. He's your creator. So if you say, I cannot believe, you are accusing God for not making you to believe, because he said you can believe. So believe in Jesus Christ. We weren't there. We believe in him. We weren't there. So if you listen to the word of God today, if you are hearing us today, don't be offended, because Jesus Christ told the religious people that you are offended because you don't know God. Don't act as if to say you know God when you get offended because you hear Jesus Christ. Because that man is a king. That man is going to be the one to judge the living and the dead. Jesus went to hell, took the key, defeated the devil. He took the key of hell. He defeated the devil. He had a victory over the devil. He had a victory over death. He died and rose from the dead. He's alive today. You can't trust him with your life. You can trust Jesus with your life. See, man is a spirit. When you check out of your body, you are a spirit. Your body is your legal right for you to live here on earth. Your body is your legal right. So you are a spirit. You cannot accuse God for not making you to believe. You cannot accuse God. God is welcoming you to his kingdom. God is calling you to his kingdom. God loves every human being. God said, I call you beloved. Beloved, what manner of love the Father has bestowed upon us What a good news. What manner of love. What kind of love. What kind of love. What amount of love that God has given unto you, that you are called a child of God. Do you know? Do you know who you are? Do you know who you are? In the eyes of God, God is not accusing you. In the eyes of God, because of the blood of Jesus Christ, God is looking at every human being with the eyes of the blood of Jesus Christ. That blood of Jesus Christ takes away the sin of the whole world. What it means is that you are holy, you are righteous, you are clean, you are washed, you are, because of the blood of Jesus. Because of the blood of Jesus, you are clean, you are washed, you are made holy. But you've got to accept. If you don't accept, you are saying what's gonna be is gonna be. No. You are saying what is going to be is going to be. No. You woke up this morning and you did not say what is going to be is going to be. No. You woke up, you dressed up, you came out of your house, and you did not say, God is up to you. No, you did everything this morning, and here you are, God is talking to you, calling you, repent, believe in Jesus Christ. Change the way you are thinking. Change the way you are thinking. He loves you. He is not accusing you. He said, therefore, being justified by faith, being made righteous, being declared righteous by faith. So faith is you believing in God that you don't see. Although we don't see the virus, we don't see the oxygen, you know.